Falcon Headed Overseer sent from Atum and watches the realm of the living in his name. They can even come close to Artorn, the sun's dial, and follow him as he transverses the inner sphere from the east to the west on his chariot in the sky and plunge deep down into the realm of Seath, the keeper of the dead, when dawn arises. Be your reverence to Atum boundless. After these explanations, my guard carried on and took me to the central temple, where the extended hall with the enormous pillars of Amun stood, that gave reference to the numerous researchers in the service of and the praise of Amun. There he directed me into the chambers of confinement, where the studies of the rules of Atum were carried out. Soon after, I stood in the office of my master. The image shows the great hall of the Temple of Amun at Karnak. You see the statues of the revered. And the temple staff walking around with the engravings on the walls and the monument statues all over the place. Are you Potiphar, the fan-bearer friend and one of the finest followers of Pharaoh? I ask humbly. Not exactly, he answered. My honorary name is Nachimutuk Gopalswami Ankhte Amun, he who spends the abundances of life through his wells of Amun. And I have settled my house in the gardens of Pharaoh. The officials of Pharaoh have provided me with great splendor. They have put gift after gift from Pharaoh on my shoulders, and my house has grown rich ever since after. Now I am the overseer of many scribes who carry out my duties and enrich my merits abundantly. I am happy that you have arrived at my place finally, Potiphar continued. I have noticed you first when I saw you on the markets of the east, where the merchants of Mitanni display their goods and the servants which they summoned from the vast plains and highlands of the Aryan realm, including you. I overheard a discussion that you waged with a couple of temple scribes addressing the outburst of the fires of Amun from Aton, the dial of the sun through which shines the Most High who cannot be named. You mentioned that you think that the fires of Amun could be distracted in the atmosphere of Aton, thus slashing back to the counterfeit of Aton like hitting one of his cheeks. It was your opinion that Aton certainly wouldn't like this and that he consequently could intensify the release of the wrath of Amun through his mouth. As you know, it is the will of Pharaoh that everything possible has to be undertaken to prevent a major outburst of Amun's wrath from Aton, which would hit the world of the living and thus threaten and bringing enduring hardship to the realm of Pharaoh. We are the agents of Pharaoh who send out messengers and probes for taking measurements into outer space and close to the counterfeit of Aton, using the techniques of Amun's fires domesticated. Yet Aton is so fearsome that he doesn't allow our probes to enter his closer vicinity. So our measurements are nothing but remote images of what is actually going on in Aton's face. They come down on us like dreams that still need an interpretation. I sense you are quite good in interpreting dreams, I think your interpretation of slashing in Aton's face is correct. I would like to invite you to continue with your interpretations of Pharaoh's dreams in this place, and Pharaoh would be happy to employ you. I give you at hand all the resources we have and needed for your investigations. You have proven to be quite independent thinker. So it will not affect you much for me not being able to lend you a helping hand oftentimes, but since it is one of my manifold duties in the service of Pharaoh to keep in contact with our co-researchers in the realm of Amudaya at the Oxus River or in Anyang, the capital of the magnificent civilization of the Xiongnu. Both are very remote countries which require me to venture out on extended travel. This is how I became an interpreter of dreams in the service of Pharaoh. As time passed by, I was on my way to the inner sanctuary of the temple of Amun. This was the library where the holy scrolls with the